We put up these facades, these attitudes, these personality traits that aren't ours. We put them up so that we can feel better about ourselves. So we can fit into the social system of things. See, Clyde didn't have this outer shell. He was purely himself. He believed in what he said and he spoke what he meant. But, as they say, the nail that sticks out gets hammered. That was Clyde. Clyde was that nail.
After what happened to Tommy by the bridge and me by the river, it was clear that things had gotten out of hand and that I had to dig us out of this mess somehow. A new age was dawning, an age of materialistic and superficial people. It was a glorious time. Clyde tried to go and play peacemaker. He tried to go and meet Mickey and Rick without me. And, well, what can I say? They didn't go easy on him. When Ben found out about the meeting, he rushed there as soon as he could. But by the time he was there, Mickey and Rick had already left, and Clyde was far gone. I was slowly losing my mind. Through lack of sleep and other things, I just couldn't deal with the problems right now. I considered going to the country. I was about to leave with everything I had, all the money and everything. But if I did leave, chances are Ben would come after me too. So that's what he does. He has no limits. So, what are my options? Well, I could always just go to the country. And if I go to the country, I'll get clean from everything. Clean slate. I would have a fresh start. No one would bother me there. But someday, I just know it. Ben would come after me.
Saying your law for the olive boys down in the house of corrections as they try for love and then in form of ascension. Am I on the right train?
I mean, ever since we were kids, the guy was a maniac.
What say you, Lord? Am I living wrong? Do you see a long road with no one on it? And the right of men that you learnt only to forget. You see my sad wife and my high margin of profit. You don't care at all. You don't care.
Now, wouldn't this be a shitty and unrealistic ending? Well, yeah. So instead, I didn't get on the train.
I made a phone call and told everyone where Mickey's stash was. After that, well, the rest was history.
Would you like to make a report, please?
He was taken care of for me.
The end of it.
I love the colorful clothes you wear and the way the sunlight plays upon her head.
I'm supposed to be happy that Mickey's not gonna be around to bother me anymore, and that Rick is far gone. I'm not. The way I see it, my best friend's dead, my other friend's in the hospital, and me, I just about destroyed any kind of opportunity I ever had. Through boredom, I seek this lifestyle that I cherish so much, that I glorify. And at first it was nice, yeah, I mean, oh God, it was awesome. But after a while, being a playboy only gets you so far. And it wasn't long before I realized that once you go down the rabbit hole, there's no coming out. So here I am, surrounded by this metropolis, this great city, so much to do. I'm just thinking, maybe it wouldn't have been so bad just to be bored in this city. Just to have nothing to do. That wasn't good enough for me. I threw my life away for an idea. That idea failed me. And this is my life.
C'est la vie, Clyde.